Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Press Start to Play. Once again, I'm your host Ayush, and once more, I'm joined by the inevitable Manas Joy and the indispensable Sushir Rahman from the other side of the globe. Say hi, guys.
Hello.
All right, and we are. This has been a busy week for all of us, and we're going to be talking about a lot of games today. All three of us have been playing some different games. I've been spending my time with Ghost of Tsushima, the Iki Island expansion, and also got some hands-on on the Diablo open beta. Sushir has been playing the Diablo open beta. He has been playing Road 96. Is that the name?
Yeah.
And you also got a chance to play 12 minutes, right?
Right. Yeah.
Sushir. And then Manas also got a chance to play 12 minutes, Road 96. And what else have we been? Psychonauts 2.
Right? Psychonauts
2 is better.
Yeah.
We're going to be talking about all of these games in detail and, you know, picking them apart slowly and steadily. Which games do you guys want to start off with?
I want to hear about Tsushima.
You want to hear about Tsushima? Yeah. Tsushima is, I enjoyed it. Like that, from the moment I picked it up, I knew like this is going to be another, 8 and 10 hours of Tsushima goodness. First of all, like whenever like that game in itself, the Ghost of Tsushima game in itself, it's like you just want to keep that share mode on all the time. Like every 5 seconds, there is something new to look at, and like there is something new visual that you can create. And like the game obviously helps you, like it pushes you into directions where there are panoramas that you're looking at. And it has that open world thingy going on where something to do is not too far away at any point of time. But that's like the average core design from Sucker Punch, right? But like also Iki expansion is more of that, you know? So like in the main story, you have, it's shown that, you know, Jin's father died early. So the story kind of centers on that now. Like, how did Jin's father die? Where? So, basically, it's set up like his father died on the Iki Island invasion, right? So, unlike the game, where like the main game, you know, where the locals are like sympathetic towards Jin throughout the entire campaign, he's like fighting for them against the Mongols. So, when he arrives on Iki, for the same reason, where you know the Mongols are there, they are trying to. So there is a new leader among them. It's like a Khatun, some Khatun name. So she's like the female leader. She's like the witch doctor for the Mongols. So she's come to Iki. She's setting up shop. Jin comes to, you know, try to take her down. But here the locals are not receptive to the samurai regime because of the invasion that his father had did earlier. And so initially, at least for the first like 50% of the game, you don't have that local support with you. Like wherever you go, people, you are obviously hiding your own identity because you are Jin Sakai, okay? And your father, Kazumasa Sakai, is called the Butcher of Iki. You know, So he's like, he's so badly misrepresented in that island. They're like, they hate him. It's like this. So he doesn't even tell his full name in the beginning when he's like caught by the locals and all that stuff. So he has to hide that. So it's like, that's like a reverse of the Tsushima Island thing that they've done. I would have liked if they would have stayed with it a little bit longer, because towards the end, like 50% of the game in, you still have like their support because you're not telling them the truth. Like you're not telling them that you're Jin Sakai. So you still have their support. It would have been nice to see it completely reversed. Like go anywhere, everybody is like against you. You know, they could have done something with the mask and the bandanas, you know, like cover your face, don't wear your proper armor and go into these places.
Yeah.
Things that other RPGs have done, I think that would have made that like plot point more interesting, I would have said, I would think. And then this, like, so the whole story is about like how the Khatun basically gives you a hallucination, halogen, like what do you call it? A hallucination drug, basically. Right. And so and to overcome it, like you see Jin's experience with his father. There are multiple points in the story where, you know, there are flashbacks to his guilt. And like the Khatun is trying to manipulate him using that guilt for not saving his father and join her army. And he's trying to fight it. So it's very nice. Like, so just say, just a main game, mein, you go to these shrines, you go to these like haiku places and like challenges, right? So in the Iki Island, wherever you go, like that voice of the cartoon follows. So it will change and there will be like some counterproductive messaging. So every time you're working with the readers, she will, like, that voice will come out and say, like, why are you helping people that killed your father and vice versa? So it's like doubt coming into his mind, talking to you back.
Okay.
Right. So I liked it. That was the story aspect of it. And obviously the main storyline is like, push the Mongol out of Iki. You know, and then there are those, legendary quests as well for one of the armors. Now there is a horse armor as well, you know, and now you can hit people with your horse like a battering ram. That's pretty insane, actually. That's not too bad. And like everything works, you know, like it's everything just works. It just like matches with what you want to do, what you want to expect. And I jumped into the game like about 6 to 8 months later. And still, I was like, it took me like 5 minutes to pick it up. So when I left it in like on the highest difficulty. So I went back, I didn't change the difficulty at all. And it was pretty, but I picked it up and it went smoothly from there. So mechanically, like if you say like on the standard combat of Tsushima, where you have like these stances that you have to change according to enemies, right? So now you have enemies who have multiple weapons. So let's say he starts off with a spear, and if you beat him like twice, he will change into a shield and sword. And if you knock that sword off, not the shield off, he'll take out two swords. So like the same enemy can have different stances. So even for the same enemy, you need to change stances again and again to match his flow. And there are these shamans, like, so they're like support buffs. So they can fight also, but as long as they're alive, all the other enemies around them are stronger, like they are more resistant to damage, and they like attack you even though you are hitting them and all that stuff, and they don't get scared that easily. So it's like those are the additions combat wise, mechanically wise. Apart from that, like collectibles. So they have these collectibles which are like flashbacks with Jim's father, and there are like addition to that, you have these shrines. Which are like pet sanctuaries. So there's like a shrine, which is like a cat sanctuary. So there are lots of cats there. And if you play the flute, right? So I'm not sure if you know, like when Infamous came out, it had this mechanic where you could use the controller to move and paint stuff.
I like, remember. Graffiti, wo right. Vandalize karne ke liye.
Yeah, right. So here they have used that to basically do an animated version of Flappy Bird. So you move your controller to keep your flutes pitch in like a line, like a Guitar Hero stuff. And once you finish that tune, like that sanctuary gets unlocked, and like more and more cats can come in, and then you can pet them. So you have a cat sanctuary, you have a deer sanctuary, you have a monkey sanctuary. It's very nice, pretty good. Apart from that, like there is also 3 extra shines, which are like puzzles. And these 3 shines are like references to God of War, Bloodborne, and the Shadow of the Colossus. So they have like these puzzles, which are like not your standard set of puzzles. You know, I won't spoil them. So you have to do something different. And it's like not straightforward that deposit this and deposit that. It's something that you'll have to read. It's in reference to those games. And you'll be rewarded with like with costumes and like headbands. So like I recently unlocked the Shadow of the Colossus thing. So it had like, you know, that like the shadow, that Colossus feature, like that face on the cover, like when you think Shadow of the Colossus, the first Colossus face that you think of.
Right.
On the cover. That's like the face mask that you get as an unlocked statement.
Okay.
And like a hood, which has that Shadow of the Colossus mark on it. So it's very nice. It's very well done. I think it's not a, it's not an afterthought. It's well thought out. It fleshes out the story. It fleshes the character of Jin. And like, even if you're playing it for the first time, this game, part becomes accessible after the second act. So by that time, you'll have the access to the hook, basically. That's because that's a mechanic that's being used in that game in a different way in the Iki Island. So you can play that there because the story kind of doesn't really depend on what you've been doing in Tsushima or if you're beating the Khan or not. So I did it after the game, after I completed the entire game. I'm
तो यू
thinking
हैड
of an
फिनिश्ड द
percentage.
मेन कैंपेन एंटायरली एंड देन यू तो मैप जब खोला तो इकी आइलैंड वाला दैट थिंग वाज देयर
Yeah,
ऑलरेडी.
so हाँ, so it's like you know how like in Division 2, when you went to New York, you had to go to New York and then like finish all the stuff and then come back. So it's the same. Like, so there is like a quest will open up in the main Tsushima Island, which will take you to Iki, and then once you're done with Iki, then you can come back to Tsushima.
Got it, got
So
it.
like once you're on Iki, you that's the only map that you will see.
Got it. Got
And can this quest be triggered any time? Like even right at the start?
Not at the start, after Act 2. So it's like, so it starts off like a standard quest that there is some report on like some part of this island. So you go to that part of that island and there you see all these people who have lost their mind. And then you realize they come from Iki. So you decide to go to Iki. That's how it's set up, basically.
एंड जैसे लेजेंड्स में थोड़ा सुपर नेचुरल एलिमेंट्स वगैरह इसमें ऐसा कुछ है? हैव दे गॉन इनटू दैट?
नहीं, नॉट रियली, बट इट्स मोर लाइक साइकोलॉजिकल. सो लाइक ऑल
ओके
दी एवरीथिंग दैट यू सी इज लाइक एट व्हाट लाइक इनिशियली इट इज वेरी क्लियर व्हाट जिन इज सीइंग इज अ विजन एंड लाइक इट्स एन हेलुसिनेशन एंड व्हाट इज रियल. बट टुवर्ड्स द एंड इट्स लाइक हिज विजन्स एंड हिज हेलुसिनेशन काइंड ऑफ मिक्स टुगेदर, रियलिटी मिक्स टुगेदर. सो ही इज गेटिंग कंफ्यूज एज टू व्हाट्स रियल एंड व्हाट्स नॉट. सो दैट वाज लाइक अ गुड प्ले एंड इट हैज दिस लाइक अमेजिंग battle where like जैसे initially in Tsushima you have these sieges, right, where you lay sieges to the castles that you're doing. In this one, like you are basically with the raiders and you are getting sieged basically. So like you set up a castle, you set up a defense post, you set up not defense in the castles per se, but like in a battlefield open area, and you are being assaulted by the Mongol army from all places. It's very hectic and like it's like on the opposite side of it. Like instead of you being the attacker, you're like kind of defending your army. And so you're in the middle of the battlefield and you set up like people to inform you, like as soon as the enemies come from one direction. So there's one point in the game when fireworks from everywhere going off. And it's like it's because like you're surrounded and people are coming in from everywhere. So it sets up that tone very well. So you go one that you go east, you go north, and then you see it's coming on from everywhere. So you recede, you fall back, you have that stand and all that stuff. So it's very well done. Like it has those like emotional waves where it goes up combat-wise, it comes down. There is like point where you're thinking about the character itself and like the people that you're meeting. It's very well done.
एंड ये जैसे गोस्ट ऑफ सुशिमा में आई रिमेम्बर लाइक द माई फेवरेट पार्ट, एक तो एक्सप्लोरेशन के अलावा इन इन कॉम्बैट इट वॉज बेस्ट वेन यू फाइटिंग लाइक वन और टू पीपल. इसमें वैसे मोमेंट्स ज़्यादा है या फिर आर देर लाइक लार्जर स्केल बैटल्स मोर ऑफ दोज?
हाँ, आई थिंक लाइक कभी कभी हो जाता है लाइक व्हेन यू गेट स्टक बिटवीन लाइक 3 to 4 स्पीयर पीपल एंड दे जस्ट लाइक दे मेक अ मॉकरी आउट ऑफ यू. मतलब ऐसा लाइक तीनों तरफ से आ रहे शीश कबाब, बट दोस लाइक इट्स आई थिंक इट्स मोर अबाउट यू. लाइक इट्स लाइक द वेपन्स एट योर डिस्पोजल एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम ना, इट्स लाइक इट्स asking you to use those weapons
Got it,
to
got
like
it.
create distance, to use those kunai, to use the smoke bomb. Because if you just like against a larger army, if you just depend on like blocking and dodging, you'll probably die fast. So it's
Okay.
asking you, and those like ammos are available, भर के available है. ऐसा नहीं है कि you have to hold back anywhere. Now they have the added option key. You can also have saddles on your horse, and
Okay.
that can store extra ammo that you collect across एवरीवेयर. सो
ओके ओके
वो है थोड़ा सा आई थिंक. बट हैविंग सेड दैट, वैसा बहुत ही कम होता है कि लाइक यू आर लाइक फोर पीपल, यू आर आउट नंबर्ड 4 to 1. मोस्टली दे फॉलो लाइक दी बॉलीवुड लॉजिक ऑफ फाइटिंग वेर ओनली वन कम्स अप टू यू एंड वंस यू डन विद देम देन द अदर वन कम्स अप टू यू.
सो अपार्ट फ्रॉम लाइक पुशिंग जिन्स बैक स्टोरी फॉरवर्ड you know in this Iki Island expansion, is there anything else that the director's cut does that you really liked, especially on the PS5?
There's like all these things are there, like the vibration in the controller, and there's this point where you have this final battle where hallucinations end, and so the voice is coming from the PS5 speaker or the controller speaker to give it that feel, थोड़ी सी अलग सी फील देने के लिए. तो विच हैज बीन डन बिफोर, बट नाउ लाइक द रंबल थिंग, वेल लाइक व्हेन यू थ्रो द कंट्रोलर, व्हेन यू लैंड ऑन द व्हेन यू जंप फ्रॉम अ हाई प्लेस and you land on grass and land on stone, so that's a different rumble. When your horse is running on grass or stone, it's a different rumble. So all these things like translate really well to the DualSense controller, which is like aisa bahut bada difference nahi hai. Like there are parts when I had the controller on the table and I was just looking at the story and it rumbled. So and I thought I was missing out, okay, because all these rumbles like aisa nahi ki bas vibrate kar raha hai. It's like they give you a different feel and the tension on the like jaise in Tsushima when you were using the long bow, right? So there was a timer on the bow, like when you knock an arrow, there was a limit to how much longer you can hold it off.
Yeah.
So in the original game, there was like no tension. Like you hold it, and once the timer goes off, it just goes off from your arrow. But in the expansion, you can feel the tightness on the trigger. That's giving way. Like just that trigger becomes tighter to hold as time goes on, and like obviously it snaps. Then it the trigger loses all tension at once. Mm. So that's like a good translation of something mechanically back to the DualSense vibration stuff.
Yeah, I'm happy to hear that they're sticking with like utilizing the DualSense in this way in their first party titles. Mm-hmm. At least, अच्छा ये I've heard about ना Tsushima का DualSense stuff. It's awesome, but also like DualSense के अलावा जैसे they already had the 4K 60 FPS mode. Visually और कुछ enhancements है क्या? नहीं ना, that's
yeah. I think this is locked at 4K 60. मतलब I didn't change the graphic video performance at all. The one thing was like I think थोड़ा मुझको लगा कि वाटर कुड हैव बीन बेटर फॉर अ गेम दैट लुक्स सो ब्यूटीफुल द वाटर कुड हैव बीन बेटर वो थोड़ा सा मतलब इट स्टैंड्स आउट ऐसा है लाइक यू कैन क्लियरली सी दैट द वाटर इज नॉट द सेम क्वालिटी एज द एंटायर रेस्ट ऑफ द गेम ऐसा है एंड इट बग्स मी नो एंड मतलब ऐसा जैसा बिल्कुल एक पॉइंट पे especially when you're in the coastal area and you have to jump in the water and do stuff na to kafi weird ho jata hai
it's not even like it's flowing streams na jaise horizon mein bhi pani itna acha nahi hai but at least it's flowing to itna pata nahi chalta it's still na to it's too still lakes wagera jo is
yeah and like wet sand matlab bhai aisa like I can feel the vibration on the controller when I'm walking on sand I look behind me I can see footprints being made in the sand theek hai and when water comes over I can see them disappearing इतना काम करा है पर वो वाटर पे काम नहीं किया मतलब ऐसा बेसिकली मतलब
आई थिंक दे आर अपिंग द गेम ऑन द होराइजन सीक्वल रिगार्डिंग द वाटर
या
एंड आई थिंक थोड़ा ऐसा है ना कि लाइक देयर इज नॉट अ लॉट ऑफ वाटर नेविगेशन इन्वॉल्वड इन गोस्ट ऑफ सुशीमा तो जैसे लाइक यू डोंट हैव टू डू अ लॉट ऑफ स्विमिंग व्हिच आई एम ग्लैड मतलब मुझे पता आई डोंट नो अबाउट अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल बट आई हेट अंडर वाटर एक्सप्लोरेशन टू मी इट डजंट मेक सेंस क्योंकि वो जो मैकेनिक होता है ना एक्सप्लोरेशन में ऐसा होता है आई थिंक कि यू have to give the player time if he wants to like explore so theek hai so you cannot be ki you have 60 seconds to go down and explore or else you will come out of bed theek hai so whatever 30 seconds to go down 30 seconds to come back up that's what are you going to explore in that dive that's my opinion of on underwater stuff
some mostly. Games do this so, na like you can bubbles aa rahe hote hai to you stand in the bubble and suddenly you get more oxygen
हाँ तो मतलब आई नेवर लाइक पर्सनली आई नेवर लाइक अंडर वाटर एक्सप्लेनेशन एट ऑल इसी वजह से मैंने कोई ब्लैक फ्लैग भी नहीं खेला कभी लाइक नॉट अ लॉट इट जस्ट बॉगल्स माय माइंड कि अभी मुझको पानी पे एक्सप्लोर करना है इतना तो उन्होंने आइलैंड बना रखे हैं ठीक है उसके बाद फिर पानी में भी जाओ डूब के वहां पर ढूंढ के लाओ शार्क के बीच में से निकल के एक चीज वहां पर भी पड़ी होगी कुछ ना कुछ
और कि वर रीब्रीदर और समथिंग ना जैसे स्क्यूबा डाइविंग किट या कुछ दे दो
नहीं मतलब जैसे आई डोंट नो आई जस्ट फील कि दैट मतलब इट डजंट अपील टू मी ऑनेस्टली दैट्स व्हाट आई एम सेइंग लाइक कि अंडर वाटर में जाकर ऐसा मुझको बहुत मजा नहीं आता कि हाँ या इसके ब्रोकन शिप के अंदर यहाँ पर जाओ ऐसा लाइक जैसे उस तरह से दिखता नहीं है मुझको आई डोंट सी द अपील इन इट बट आई डू सी द अपील इन गोस्ट ऑफ सुशीमा बाय द वे लाइक इट्स गॉटन मी बैक ऑन द हॉर्स लिटरली And I'm now thinking I'll play the Legends mode as well this time and finish it probably.
Okay, and there's like one community question that I have that has been asked in one of the groups, and I wanted to ask you that. So the question was that with Sony going ahead with director's cut for two of its games, do you think like this is the way forward for Sony? Like you know, once they're out with the game, like what is the reason for like it to be dubbed as a director's cut? Is it like the same as the GOTY bundles like before? Or is it like a little different, like what Kojima is trying to do?
जैसे गोटी एडिशन तो ऑब्वियसली यार लाइक दे कम आफ्टर ऑल द डीएलसीज हैव कम, ऑल द एक्सपेंसेस हैव कम एंड दे लाइक इन कंसोलिडेटेड एग्रीगेशन ऑफ ऑल दैट हैज कम बिफोर देम, है ना. सो देयर इज दैट. जैसे डायरेक्टर्स कट में आई थिंक देयर इज लाइक न्यूएंस एडेड टू इट. आई एम नॉट श्योर. जैसे कोजिमा इज कोजिमा. मैं आई डोंट कंसिडर कोजिमाज वर्क टू बी लाइक पार्ट ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री टू बी फ्रैंक, बिकॉज ही डज एवरीथिंग डिफरेंटली इन ऑल ऑन ऑल सेंस ऑफ द वर्ड्स, राइट. सो तो डायरेक्टर्स का थोड़ा सा मिसनॉमर है, बिकॉज ऐसा कुछ है नहीं इसमें कि लाइक इट डजंट ऐड एनीथिंग न्यू टू द ओरिजिनल फ्लो. तो जैसे जैसे व्हाट्स दैट्स व्हाट एक्सपेक्टेड इन डायरेक्टर्स कट, राइट. लाइक यू गेट टू सी डिलीटेड सीन्स, यू गेट टू सी पार्ट्स व्हिच द डायरेक्टर हैड वांटेड टू ऐड टू द मूवी बट कुडंट. दैट डजंट नेसेसरली अप्लाई टू इट, बट इट डज ऐड समथिंग न्यू. इट्स लाइक अ डीएलसी एक्सपेंशन एंड विद ऑल द स्टफ दैट दे एडिंग फॉर द PS5. सो इन दैट सेंस लाइक द ओरिजिनल गोस्ट ऑफ सुशीमा इज गेटिंग PS5 अपडेट्स. सो इट इज गेटिंग न्यू कंटेंट विच काइंड ऑफ एलिवेट्स द ओरिजिनल कंटेंट. So you can say that that's the way director cut is working, and if that's the direction that they go with, it's not a bad direction to go on. Like you already have God of War there, and let's say you get something like God of War director's cut with added commentary around level play design and all that stuff, with all these rumble stuff added onto the DualSense controller and stuff. It's not a bad option to go with, you know. If for people who have not played God of War, because like I've said it multiple times, I think anybody who wanted to play God of War has already played God of War by this time,
Yeah.
you know. So it's not a bad way to go into it, but I think just the PS5 features are would not be enough to merit a director's cut price, I would say. Like there would have to be something new content for me to jump on. Like if this was just like a like the PS5 upgrade came out for Last of Us 2 as well. It came out for Days Gone. It came out for God of War as well. But I didn't play any of those games because I already finished them. If there was something new, a new DLC, like which is in the case of Ghost of Tsushima, that's something I definitely wanted to try. So, and that takes me back. Maybe if I not finished the entire game and there were more, like I am in the position now where I am thinking I'll grab up the collectibles now and finish the legend modes. So, which I was not. And I was not there when the initial legend modes came out. So I think it's a good entry point back into the game from that perspective. If that
And
answers your question, Sushil.
and final question, did you actually play it in the purest mode, as in with the Japanese voiceover and English
Jenny, arigava,
subtitles?
no man, no, I didn't. Like I had tried the that mode when the game had first came out, and I played like around 1 to 2 hours of it, and it's nice. Like if you are into that kind of thing, like just say like if you're into anime and you are into that part where you watch anime in the original language with subtitles, then I think you would have enjoyed that. But I prefer that game is so beautiful. Why watch it in black and white? That's my like main objection with it, you know. And yeah. That's I think like try it if you want to. It's like a gimmick. Try it if you want to. But if it's but I would suggest you play it 4K 60 FPS. Turn up your TV as much as you can, and you know enjoy the game. I challenge you not to take a screenshot every 10 minutes. Like that's my challenge with Tsushima. That's how good that good looking that game is.
उसका फोटो मोड भी तो फाड़ू है ना, विद लाइक एवरीथिंग इन मोशन.
बहुत Yeah, everything. Like मुझे पता है, like I was playing the game, I had to put down the controller at one point, and I was talking to Vasudha. So it was midday, and it like the cycle went on from midday to night to dawn while I was talking to her, and all three seasons, like all those three times, look amazing. मतलब ऐसा, like every time you want to take a screenshot at that point in the game,
Yeah.
वहीं
देखने
पर खड़े
तो
जगह, एक जगह पे खड़े खड़े.
they made a good looking game, huh? Like the next part, I'm excited. Like what more they do with the series.
वैसे सकर पंच का ऐसे ही है यार. लाइक इवन इनफेमस व्हेन इट केम
Yeah.
आउट, इट वाज ब्यूटीफुल. लाइक सिएटल वगैरह में ऊपर जाओ, स्क्रीनशॉट्स वगैरह लेने में मजा आता था. लाइक आई
Yeah.
रिमेम्बर डूइंग दैट टू. यप, सो दैट गोस टू सुशीमा गाइस.